maybe I could teach you something that, that would help you in what you, how you want to operate. Me and Keith both have a four-element quad on the back of our vehicles. Basically, I use mine just to get attention, just let people know we're out there. I mean, it works just as good. One of them worked just as well. You don't really need that quad at all. Keith uses his all the time, but, and Keith does good. Keith's the winner for the year. I mean, it's bad when you get beat by a blind guy, you know, that can't walk. That's the way it is. This is our basic antenna. This is in all the, it's all over the website. I forget what the, homein.com, I think. These are on that. And it's a three of them, Yagi. And they've got the dimensions on this, how to build it, and everything. That's, this is your basic unit. But when you get closer into the box, let's say he's putting out more than 2 watts, you get in 3 miles with 25 watts, you're probably going to need some attenuation. So if you're going to hunt, it don't have to be attached to this. I've got one here that it is attached to. So that's the little that's a active attenuator. I think Tim bought this at AM Fest for about $5 or something. Okay, you can't build it for that. But it takes a battery and you have to turn your frequency 500 off, I think. That's 4 megahertz offset. So you'd have to be 4 megahertz off to the frequency you're listening to receive. This will get you close, but if you don't have attenuation, you're not gonna, you may not be able to get there. I've got another attenuator here.
Be careful your HT, that one's not cut off.
Oh man, somebody else is over. This is a, that's a lot active attenuator. This is inactive, I guess. It's passive. There you go, that's what I was looking for. It's made by Arrow antennas. I still have trouble with that on some of the hunts when I get close, because it will come past that sometime in the morning. You'll be close when it does it, but you still can't really point. Sometimes you can't point when you get within a half mile of it, or maybe a quarter mile or something. But I think that's all Keith uses in it. I don't think he uses the active at all. I think he uses one like this. So that's the two basic attenuators. So you could eat, and I built one of these. There's another one that somebody built. That's an active one. So they're different shapes and sizes. Here's one I built. It looks more like the Arrow. That's a solid chunk of aluminum I cut, hauled out, and put the stuff in. So, but you do, you need an antenna and an attenuator. And you can throw that in your car, get out, take the readings, what we do. Since it's mileage based, you don't want to pull off a long way to take the readings, because tents add up. So every time you pull 3/10 off to get in that parking lot over there, you've just lost 3/10 of a mile. So if you can get just barely off the highway the way you're headed, you know, you're better off. But generally, we have a lot of hunts that we're close on, we're 2 or 3 tenths apart, so it does make a difference. But as a beginner fox hunting, just get there. We don't care how long, you know, as long as it's less than 2 hours, just hunt and get there. Don't worry about winning or losing or whatever. Generally the hunt is won by the guy that didn't make a mistake on getting there. I mean, everything fell in for him that day. Because 2 meters not that accurate. You can't get, just because you got a bearing that way, that doesn't mean the fox is that way. You could miss it 20 degrees this way, 20 degrees that way. So if it's your lucky day, you may just win regardless, you know. If two of you happen to have the same luck, then it's gonna add up to a little things when you pull off.
Is everybody doing on 2 meters, or do they use other bands too?
Most of us done on 2 meters. They do have an 80 meter hunt. I don't know if they do that mobile. they do an 80 meter on Foxhunt.
Nothing on 4.4 here?
Not that I know of, Hal. Anything on that.
But you could.
Probably could. I don't know why you couldn't.
I've done one of them for 40.
Huh?
I've done one of them for 40, but it was rare.
Yeah. I did an on-foot 80 meter hunt, ARDF hunt, and it's a five transmitter hunt. And the way they do that is each transmitter is on for a minute and off for 4 minutes. And you've got to find, you want to find all five of those in a place like Springmont Park. Each transmitter has to be a half mile apart. You're on foot. Figure it up, you're about 3 hours away from the finish line. And so you've got to find all the transmitters you can and still get to the finish line before the 3 hours is up. So if you find three and get in, I found three at one in Ohio, and I got there a minute and a half late, you lose it all. So I could see it, but I couldn't get there quick enough, you know, to finish. So that's the way it goes. So that's basic setup is the tape measure beam if you want, the mat, the compass, and attenuator. You're in business as far as Foxhunt. This is a one I built years ago. Terry Hudson was down here, and he talked me into building this, so I built it, and it's called a collinear. You guys probably know what that is, but it's
a log periodic.
It's a log periodic or collinear. He called it collinear. I don't know. But it picks it, works on different frequencies. So it would work on the airplane frequency, the downed airplanes, and that sort of thing is what it's supposed to work on. But I drove it out last summer, thought, you know, I'm going to use that. And it's turned out to be one of the better moves I've made by accident. But what I do is I took Lee with me a couple months ago. So I just got my truck to tank, and Lee was coming, another kid was coming. I told Lee, I said, I don't have room, you know. I said, I don't know what. I said, can we go in your car? So yeah, we'll go in his car. Well, what you do is get you a paint roller and duct tape that to the door, top of the door, and run this down through it, in through your window, into your armrest, and that's your antenna. So you can do it on the move. I find this works so much better than stopping and getting out, because I can take a reading at a stop sign. I can stop. If they're hitting the city of Mitchell, you stop, zip, 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 exactly.
Well, you did that. Remember, I was in the left-hand turn lane near the Army Surplus Store.
Right.
And you said, no, go straight.
So this works really better than the tape measure if you're going to do it on the run. You don't have to pull off near as much to take your readings. You can just pull off the edge of the road and take a reading. If I'm going to stop and get out, I don't like being off the edge. I want to get a little further than that. But you can just stop at a T. Nobody's coming. Just sit there and take a reading. It's sticking right out your car door. I would highly recommend that. The only difficulty between this and that you can throw that right inside real quick. You're going to break the antennas. If you had a 3-element beam made like on this basis, you know, it needs to be stuck on the outside. It's kind of hard to get it in and out. So, but I really like that for that style. It wouldn't have to be a 5-element. It could be a 3-element. But that and the paint roller, put it on the car door. I'll show you what I use on mine as for the armrest. I built that sticks in my armrest hole, and this holds on the angle that my armrest sits like that, but this holds straight up and down. And I stick that in there, and I paint rollers up here on the edge of your door. I had the kid that goes with me, he was going to go, and I said, okay, so I rigged this up, and he says, I said, you're going? Yeah, I'm going. Well, come Saturday, guess what? He ain't going. Well, I didn't have one made for my side, so I had to hurry up and make one for the driver's side so I can run it myself, and I can actually run that and go down the road myself without any help, so it's kind of neat. like I say, as far as, like I say, as far as the Fox box and transmitting, you do want to remember, like I say, you can, Keith's got a mag mount that's like real tall. It's a, I don't want it, it's more than 5 acres, but it's, that's what he uses sometimes, but you can use a rubber duck to increase your output of this handheld, so you can get signal back, you know, if you're having trouble on that. I might go over the Foxhunt rules a little bit, just to make sure we cover everything. We operate on 146.565, can't exceed 50 watts PEP. Talks about the transmission cycle being 30 seconds on or 30 seconds off.
Who makes these rules up?
We make them up as we go.
Okay, so each group that's doing it's got their own.
Yeah, right.
Is there like a, I don't know, like a national group that's got rules or?
The ARDF, Amateur Radio Direction Finding Hunt, that's the five transmitter hunt, it's actually an international, it does have its own rules. But the mobile hunt, I don't think has any particular. We've made the rule, must be handicap accessible, no climbing or hiking, etc. Must be in Lawrence County, and we actually go ahead and let you go up to Lake Monroe parallel with Lawrence County. So, can't go east or west past the border of Lawrence County, but you can't go north to the lake. So, that's just a little extra. It's kind of up in the forest there. So, if you don't have a map for that, it's kind of unhandy if somebody hides a bird. We don't do a lot of birds. It's kind of like 20 miles, so it's kind of a long way, but we can if we want to. Must be on public property or public accessible property. We had one guy got confused over public property, or maybe we were confused, but one of the guys hit a Walmart parking lot. Well, that's a private parking lot, I guess, but it's public property. I mean, you can get there. We're just saying you got to be able to get there without having to go ask somebody. Spring mill's okay as long as you don't have to pay to get in. So in the wintertime, if you don't have to pay to get in, spring mill's fine.